Now we will move towards the next topic, that is known as transpose of a matrix. In this we will first learn what is the definition of transpose of a matrix. Suppose a matrix is given as A is equals to Aij. Matrix capital A, capital A denotes the matrix, and small Aij, it denotes the elements of it, and it is having order m cross n, and we all know that m cross n, where m denotes the number of row and n denotes the number of columns, right? Then the matrix obtained by interchanging the rows and columns of A, right, is called as transpose of a matrix. So that means, suppose we have any matrix, like they have taken this example, like suppose it is having 1, 2, 3, 3 row and 1 and 2. How many? 2 columns. So 3 cross 2 matrix it is. So we have elements like 3, 5, root 3, 1, 0 and minus 1 by 5, right? So if we write these row in column wise, right, the elements of row we write now in columns, right, that is, this is first row, it will get converted to first column, right? So 3, 5 will come here as 3, 5 in the first column, it will come second row, then we write in second column root 3 and 1, we will write here in column second, and third row element 0 and minus 5, we will write in third column elements. That means the row get transposed to columns and columns get transposed to row. This is the first column, so it gets changed to first row. So in this way we get the transpose of the given matrix. So if the given matrix is suppose 3 cross 2 of order, then its transpose, it will get reversed. 3 cross 2 get reversed to 2 cross 3, right? So the transpose of the matrix A is denoted by A dash. A, capital A, we used to denote it by A dash or A power capital T, right? In other words, if A is equals to capital A is equals matrix capital A is equals to Aij m cross n, then A dash means transpose of matrix A will be equals to Aji. Ji means, because here we have interchanged the row and column elements, right? So here it was Ij, now we have to write Ji, and here the previous original matrix was having order m cross n, so now the resultant matrix will have order n cross m, right? So suppose if I take a 2 cross 2 matrix, suppose I take 2 cross 2 matrix, suppose I have got elements like A, B and C and D, right? It is of order 2 cross 2. So this is suppose matrix B, if I denote this as matrix B, then its transpose will be what? Transpose means B dash, or we can also write it as B power T. It will be what? The row elements will get converted to column elements, that means A and B, it is in first row, it will come in the first column here, A, B, right? It will come in the first column, and C, D, it comes in the second row, so second row get converted to second column, and the order will remain same, because here also the number of row and number of column will be same. So A, B, first row it was in the original matrix, now it comes as AB in the first column. Second row get converted to second column, right? Suppose if I take another example, suppose C. See, if I take it as suppose 1, 2, 3. So what is the order of this matrix? It is having 1, 2 and 3. 3 row and 1 column. 3 cross 1. So its transpose C dash will be what? Now the order will get reversed. Instead of 3 cross 1, we have to write what? 1 cross 3, because we are writing its transpose. Now it is first row, it will get converted to first column. So it will be 1, 2 and 3, right? Suppose if I take example of D, suppose if I take 7 and 2, it is how much order? It is having 1 row and 2 columns, so it will be 1 cross 2. So the resultant matrix, that is transpose of D, will be what? It will be 7 and 2, that is 2 cross 1, having 2 row and 1 column, right? So this was the transpose of the matrix in which the row element get transposed, converted to column elements, and the column elements get converted to the row element, right? Now the properties, these are very important properties of transpose of a matrix. It is very important to learn these properties. We have got four properties here. Like if we suppose if I have make a transpose of a matrix, then again I take the transpose, like that means two times if I make the get the transpose of it, I will get the original matrix. What it tells us, that first property tells us that if A transpose, suppose I have taken, right, again I make a transpose of it, then I will get the original matrix, right? Okay, let's take an example of this example B, right? B was what? B was, I have taken B as A, B, C and D, right? So what it was, transpose was A, C, B and D, right? Then again I take its transpose, that is B dash dash. That means again in this matrix what I have to take, the first row will get converted to first column A, C, and the second row will get converted to the second column, so B, D. So we can see that B and B dash dash, these two matrices are same. That means transpose of a matrix. If I do two times transpose of the same matrix, then I will get the same result. Original matrix I will get. Second property tells us that K is any constant. Suppose it could be 2, 3, 7, 9, 10, anything, right? K into A, this matrix A, whole dash is equals to K into A dash. That means the constant remains the same. It does not changes, right? The second, then the third property tells us that A plus B whole dash. That means if I add two matrices and take its transpose, or if I take transpose of A plus transpose of B. Okay, if I these two results will be same. A plus B whole transpose will be equals to A transpose plus B transpose. And this one is the most important result, that is matrix A, B, these are the product of two matrices A and B. So matrix A into B whole transpose is equals to transpose of B into transpose of A. This is also the product of B. Like the order of it gets reversed. A, B whole transpose is equals to B transpose into A transpose, right? With the help of this, we can do examples. So example 20 and 21. You have to practice after this, right? Thank you.